citizens to be heard?
There are none.
And we'll go on to committee reports, planning and zoning commission, May 2nd meeting.
We had our meeting then, and we reviewed the Bethlehem conditional use permit application, and the planning and zoning commission voted for recommendation to the board, so that public hearing and the action on that will take place at the next village board meeting. They also reviewed the Wildwind final plat, and again made a recommendation for approval, and that will be at the May 18th village board meeting. And we discussed, and Bob and I will work on bringing a
review Peter Oak as trustee for term of office. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? You're back up. Yeah. Residential rehabilitation. Jason Bloxham. Lillian Baker, Gary Beck, Jeff Middleston, and Janice Poole, all 1-year terms.
I'll make a motion to approve.
All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Board of Police and Fire Commissioners. Martin Baker, a 3-year term. Tom Banker, 2-year term.
We have to change the date on here to 2019. For Tom Baker. We should make it 2019.
Yes. Yeah, that should be a 19.
With that change, I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
What?
That was my error on the agenda because Tom Banker is taking Al Hoppick's spot, which would be just the 1-year term to 2018.
So the change should be on here, the 1-year.
It should be on the agenda, but it's my error.
So then it's correct with the 2018?
Yes.
The 2018 is correct. The 2-year term is incorrect.
It was completing the term. Okay.
So he's just completing the term that I had. So with that correction, you still
make a motion to approve.
You still second. All in favor? Aye. Opposed? Thorntonville-Hortonia Fire District. Jack Conkey is trustee for term of office. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Senior Activities Committee. Carolyn Habeck is citizen member.
Second.
All in favor? Say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That takes care of the appointments. Committee and commission appointments. All have been approved and will be serving their terms. C, appointment of Jeannie Belisle to co-sign village and utility checks in the absence of clerk treasurer.
This is something that's appointed by the village president, so it's not. This one does not need those for approval.
Okay.
This is just the regular one of these.
D. R-13-17 resolution to appoint alternate
The 11,000?
Yeah.
The initial one, if you recall, the initial one was 5,000. That was in the very beginning,
right,
and that was to see if the feasibility of
right.
it. And then the other one included the mapping and all the stuff that was for that purpose. So I don't think we necessarily thought it was conservative or really one way or another. It kind of just was.
So this 1,200 wraps everything up?
Yes. From the standpoint of the mapping part of it, I don't think we have any more fees coming in from Ellers, because that was, I'm trying to think now. Other than, I know we have the contract for the recording, but I mean,
right,
that's
I don't have the timetable in front of me to see if they're involved.
Yeah,
they are still going to be involved because they are going to be working with sending the kids into the state and such, but I believe that's still under the previous contract.
Right, that's what I meant, is that was under the previous contract. And with MSA, that was just to get us to the point of approval and all the mapping. We did not include, you know, we had not really talked about this part of it.
So that.
This should be the end of it, with the exception of the ongoing costs that we had talked about last time, where Ellers will be doing the reporting for us, the state, on an annual basis, and doing
right.
the annual joint review board meetings.
They're not actually doing the reporting to the state. What they're helping us with is the joint board review meetings, making sure that we're kosher with those.
But after this is done, that's just a one-time annual event.
Yes.
The reporting procedure.
Yes, that is an annual one.
So
that's all
it, that becomes a cost, not part of the contract.
And that's all
right.
Into the TIF.
Right.
Yes.
Not that we're just going to throw money around, but that's just all part of the TIF.
Correct.
So you're looking for a motion to approve the
Yeah, I mean, it's only 1,200 technically, I don't, but
no.
I just wanted to bring it and make sure that it was, that you guys were aware of it.
So it's $1,000 more than what we have money. But you said we have
It's $1,000 more than the not to exceed amount of the original that you approved originally.
So you're looking for $1,000 more than what we originally
approved. So let's go back here. They had a time and material not to exceed 11,000. So you're telling us that this will exceed that limit?
Yes, but that time and material to not to exceed, that did not include this. We had a specific scope of work, and they met all the requirements of that scope of work. It's just that I thought if we were still under it, I could expand the scope of work to include this. But I can't because it's over the amount. So this was not included in that scope of work. We never discussed doing this work at that time.
So could this then be for 1,200 rather than 1,000?
She has 200 and some left.
Yeah, we have $243. I guess my thought is just, you know, we're done with that. And we just contract them for $1,200 to do this work.
So you're looking for approval to do the $1,200 for mapping, which was above the 400 time.
For the boundary descriptions, not for mapping.
Sorry.
Yes, correct.
My apologies.
To create the legal descriptions for the boundaries of the TIDs.
Do you have any questions about it?
I do.
Sorry.
Is this the end?
For the development of the TIDs?
Right.
This is the last.
So you're not going to come back next time and say, oh, you know what, we exceeded the 11,000, give me another 1,200, here's another $1,000. See where I'm going with this?
Sure, no.
I'm going back to what I said before. You start, this aggregate of all these little costs start dwelling, and all of a sudden you're above and beyond the $15,000 limit. That's why I'm talking. Why
sure,
wasn't this addressed initially?
Well, two reasons. One is because when we were first working on this was to get it to the approval stages. And that's what they did. That's what our contract was for. This is something that I could have gone, then this is the final part of it. I didn't realize we had to do legal descriptions. That's a new requirement, actually. And I could go to other companies and ask for this. So it was, you know, I approached them and asked them if they could add this to it, if they have the capabilities of doing this as well.
So you have 200 left.
$243.86.
And you need another 1,000.
Correct.
To cover that 1,200, is that what you're saying?
Yes, I guess I was just thinking it was completely separate and we just...
Yeah, that's why I asked. That sounded to me like it was a separate item.
Right, that I think it would be the cleanest because the original contract is not included.
Right.
It was a very specific scope of work and they have completed that scope of work. So I think it would be cleanest to just... We came in $243 under the maximum for that other one. This is a new thing.
All right. So what you need is a $1,000 approval tonight, is that correct?
That's just $1,200.
Okay. And your original time, or your original bid was 11 grand and your 200 and some underneath that?
Correct, for the other piece, yes.
So you can't take those monies and add it to...
Well, then you're muddling things because you're taking part of this one and putting it into a past one and then, if you put it all in one of the...
The original contract did not include the legal description.
Yeah, we know that.
Right, and we've been getting billed as we're going, so it's not like we've paid them and are getting money back. It's that we have not been invoiced, we've been invoiced for $10,800 and whatever.
So I'll make a motion to approve a request an additional $1,200 to complete the legal description phase of this project. So outside of the scope of the original $11,000 not to exceed agreement.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Absolutely. Funding for Opera House Kitchen Project. I think we're
going to table that.
Yeah. We're going to table this till winter. Hiring review period for personnel manual.
We'll cover that.
That will also be...
Monday, 6:45 p.m. sharp.
And come back for next board meeting. Mm-hmm. Distribute draft department head employment agreements for future discussion.
This was what was provided by Attorney Sorensen with request to draw them up. This is just for people to take and review, to write down comments or something to be prepared for a future meeting.
Distribute Wildwind Subdivision Developers Agreement for future discussions.
This is what we had mentioned that the Planning and Zoning Commission reviewed and recommended approval of the plat. So they review the plat, and ultimately this board will review and approve the plat if you choose to approve at the next meeting. And it's important to have a developer's agreement in place at the same time. So we wanted to give you the developer's agreement so that you have 2 weeks to review it. If you have any questions, to then present at the next board meeting when we will ask for approval of that and the plat. Carl has reviewed the developer's agreement. The developer has. I have. Bob has. So, and actually, this was the original one, or very similar to with minor edits from the original one back in 2008 that was approved. So,
we Bob's on the top of that.
Any other miscellaneous topics for future discussion?
I have one. I would like to talk about seeing the play before the
I also have one too. I would like to discuss the police department and its future.
decision, signed the paperwork, and then EMC came in with a lower quote. So we are still with EMC, and it came in at, like I had mentioned, is another $1,500 below the quote we got from Continental Western. And don't you spend this money right away. So because it was additional savings and I had to have it all in place by May 1st, this is just updating, and I figured it was okay for me to go ahead, and even though the board voted for EMC, the dollar amount is what is significant, and it's still under that dollar amount.
So here's company one, here's company two.
Crazy.
And they're $9,000 apart.
Yes.
So we decided to go with company one. You go back and tell company two the decision. They come back and underbid company one by $1,500.
Yes.
How do they know the price?
They
didn't divulge anything to them, did you?
It was in minutes.
Yeah, it was public.
Okay.
Yes.
So it's public record?
Yes. Yes.
All right.
Yes. And, and it's, if you recall, and this is just minor details, but I just want you to be aware for when the bills come through, the bills will look higher because this is the company that has the dividend in the end.
At the end.
So the net amount is $1,200.
And because we're with the same company, Lynn, we've always gotten those dividends at year end?
Yes.
Yes.
Exactly as proposed?
I just pulled up the last one, and it is 13% of what the premium is. And this one, they're giving us 15% of
the premium.
Okay,
so there's a follow-through, which is accurate.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
But I would like to just expand a little bit on Peter's comment. We wouldn't do that. I mean, we wouldn't bid shop our numbers to that.
I think that's illegal.
Well, it's not. It's not illegal, it's immoral.
Right.
So I just...
I had no intention.
No.
Yeah.
No, I'm not suggesting that. I'm just saying, as a point of contact, I want to.
You know, Lynn could probably go me up on this, but I can tell you that in purchasing over at the state, it is illegal to bid or get solicit bids and then use one vendor against another. That's against the law. That's state law. I don't know what it is in the local municipalities, but I'm sure you have to follow a code of ethics, if you will. So when you start bid shopping and start using one company against the other, that's...
Unfortunately, my industry doesn't fall.
Well, yeah, but you're not a government entity.
I mean, it's still wrong.
So
all it takes on our side is going back to the one company and saying we're going with the other company because we got a better price from them, and then they look at their numbers harder and then come back with a different amount.
I would totally agree with
that's
that.
Fine.
But you can't say these people underbid you by $9,000.
Right.
No, and that's actually, I had already signed the papers and was processing the one and then let the other one know thanks, but we're going to do it this way.
No, cool. I don't need one.
No, I don't either. Done. Good job.
Thank you.
So that's, that insurance is in place now. WEDC training. I put this in here because a class has come available through the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation, and it deals with business or financing and negotiation with developers and that type of stuff. It's a good course, and
Was that the email you sent out this afternoon?
No. This would be for me.
Okay.
To go to actually.
Gotcha.
And it's like $700. But I got a $200 scholarship for it so far. I'm trying to work on it more and have a relative whose house I stay at if I get to go. So I'm trying to work them down more on the price because this would be over my training budget. It's just that I know that they don't have many people in the class and they really want people to go, so they're trying to put together a package to make it more affordable. And I just think it would be a great opportunity now, especially with that we've been utilizing TID funds and things like that more.
How much is left in the budget?
I have 260 something left in my budget for training. And this one is, like I said, it's 700, but right now I've got the $200 scholarship. They said at least will be 200. It could be up to 4, and they're trying to get me the membership rates.
This is in Madison.
Yes. So just letting you be aware of it, and I'll be working with Alice once we get closer because I'm kind of playing a game.
And this is something that you think is valuable for you to grow?
I think it is. It's talking about structuring packages for developer incentives and reviewing economic development. And actually, in order to take this, you need the earlier class as a prerequisite. And fortunately, I took that when I worked for Marathon County. So.
Is this more for developers, though?
No, this one is they towed it as being for municipalities, for the municipalities that are in economic development. I know the other one that's going to is from West Bend, I think it is, or one of the communities in
the
is
this
room.
A one day?
That is three days.
It's 4 days.
No, this is that's the other one. That's the one, the prerequisite for it that I already took. So I'll be talking to Al more as we get closer to it, but I just wanted to have you guys be aware of it. Hopefully I can get it down more. Next one is Opera House Marketing. We have a resident that has been interested in helping the village, and she does some volunteer projects. And the latest one she did is that she put the Opera House on several different marketing websites that are for wedding venues. So since she did that, and it's been only a month, I've gotten 4 inquiries about weddings or baby showers type things. So I'm still learning how to use it. Haven't been able to dive into it a whole lot because I haven't had time. But she and I are both kind of doing a tag team on seeing if we can get more of those events in the Opera House and hopefully getting some more rental money so that Carl has a bigger budget for the kitchen. So
this is where your kitchen is.
Yeah.
For catering.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to eat
excuse me?
I'm sorry. Do we have air conditioning over there yet?
In the lower level.
The lower level, right?
Upstairs is something we're going to have to look at in our capital improvement.
And we've talked about that.
I think within 5 years we're going to have to get something.
Okay.
And the other one, I'm just going to axe out the summer rec shed because I did not get get the info I was looking for. So that's it for me.
Clerk Treasurer, open book date and board review date.
The open book is going to be held on Monday, May 15th from 9 to 11 a.m. here in this room. That is where the assessor is on site and people can come in and talk to him informally. Anybody who can't make those dates can make phone calls to them and take care of things over the phone. They manage to take care of a lot of questions by dealing with them in an informal manner and get adjustments that way when they convince, put it forward a convincing case, and then they avoid having to come to board of review where they have to bring more compelling evidence. And then, as I said before, the board of review is on Monday, June 5th from 6 to 8.
What date was the training for the board of review?
Training is May 19th, Friday, May 19th from 1 to 3.
I got it marked on my calendar, that's why I asked.
You and I went last time.
We went 2 years ago, so your training doesn't get to be used for this anymore. Out of date, sorry.
So what do I do?
We need to have at least one person who has had the training. This way we have two. Jeannie was going to go, but it landed on the wrong day, so I'm keeping my eyes open for something else.
Okay. So we will have you as training.
Myself and you.
Oh, you okay. You know, we can alternate too. That if we stay on this board of review, we can alternate year after year. I just can't break through that date.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's why they make sure that you can't, that you don't have to have everybody there or they have to disappear. You have to have at least one person. We've had the training within 2 years. Our training was 2 years ago and will be outdated by the time of the board of review, so we have to go again.
That's it. Director of Public Works.
I only have one item on here for Memorial Square. We have the electrical conduit in. We Energy should be over there any day now to put the electrical in. I'm still waiting on VidCon to finish up the coping for that back wall. It's unfinished right now. It'll look a lot better when that coping goes on. We also had an individual run into the flagpole, not the flagpole, and the memorial wall. A little bit of damage. I'm going to have Dan Hansen and James from VidCon come out and look at it. It's possible I may have to
where payments are made. Somebody comes in here and pays the bond for the warrant, and then we process it for the different agency. We send it out to them.
Oh.
People are allowed to come in here and pay the bond fees, and then we send it to the proper agency.
Okay, so it's just an email.
Mm-hmm.
I'll make a motion to approve that.
Okay, we've got a motion and a second. Roll call. Jeannie?
Aye.
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 Aye. Communication and miscellaneous business. Gold Cross ambulance report is in your packet. Anybody have any questions or concerns? Hearing none. We have downtown zoning task force.
They have the draft of the downtown zoning plan.